to increase the server's degrees. Hello, and today I'm going to show how to control a servo with a PIC microcontroller. First, let's go over the hardware connections. I have the signal line connected to RC1, which is the capture compare and PWM peripheral in the PIC, with a USB to serial FTDI connected to the UART. Now, a quick rundown of how a servo works. Now, a servo works by getting pulses from a PWM at a 50 Hz base frequency. Most servos work by having their 0° point at 1 millisecond, the 90° point at 1.5 millisecond pulses, and then having their 180° position at 2 millisecond pulses. But you do get some variations. Like the one they describe here is 90° at 0.5 milliseconds, and then at 2.5 millisecond pulses, it has 180°. Now, just a note on the hardware connections. Now, this is something I frequently see with hobbyists, is that they don't have a proper power supply connected to their servos. And in turn, they either burn out their PIC, their regulator, or the FTDI interface. Especially with Arduino boards. Okay, now let's have a look at the data sheet. Now we're going to use this formula to get a frequency of 50 Hz on our PIC. Now, since we want a 50 Hz frequency, we are going to place 50 Hz here in time base, and then our oscillator frequency in here. And I pre-added a prescaler of 16. To this code, and then we get a value for PR2 of 2500. Now, the problem we're sitting with here is that the PR2 register has a maximum value of 0 to 255. So, the only variable, since we've maxed out the prescaler, we can only change the oscillator frequency. Now, here we have a readjusted one, again with 50 Hz. And a 16 times prescaler, but we have changed the value of the oscillator to 500 kHz to get a reasonable value within PR2's range of 156. Now, since the oscillator frequency needs to be changed, we are going to the oscillator control register, and then from our 8 MHz base that we usually use to 500 kHz base. Now, what this also means is since we changed the oscillator frequency, we need to change the UART's frequency as well. So we go to the UART, and then we go to the baud rate generator. Now, after fiddling around, I found that this is the best configuration for the UART. Then we go down to the formula. We use this formula, and this 64 corresponds to this value in the baud rate formulas. Then we use this formula to calculate out the baud rates. Now, using the formula, we replace in a 16 here. We have our oscillator frequency over here, and then our target baud rate over here, which gives us a value for baud rate generator of 103, which gives us an actual baud rate of 348 bits per second. I just arbitrarily picked 300 for this since it was the easiest. Now, please note, when you have a value for your baud rate, please plug it back in and check what your actual baud rate is you are going to get out, because you can sometimes get ridiculous baud rates. Now, let's get to coding. Now, this code is the base code of the PWM from my previous video. What's currently set in the code is I have my high priority interrupts, I have my PWM count variable that just keeps track of where the PWM is currently. I have a data variable for my UART, and then I have a boolean to tell the UART if there is data from the PC. Then I just have a print buffer if I need to print out something, then a function to set the current PWM duty cycle. Then I currently have the oscillator set to 8 MHz. Just some LED outputs, which I'm not using in this tutorial. The UART initialization function. I set RC1, which is the PWM output, to 0 to make it an output. The timer 2 register with a prescaler of 0. PR2 register set to 0. Two values of the PWM set to 0. Caption compare register low set to 0. And the base interrupt setups. Then I enable timer 2, and then I have a printout just to show me my program has started, and then I just set the PWM output. Then I got in the main loop a boolean detect for when data has been received from the PC via UART. And then in the high priority interrupt, I have the UART receive where I pull the data from the UART and then tell my main loop I have data to process. And then nothing in the low priority interrupt. These two values are just values I preset up earlier so I don't burn out another server from checking what the actual values are of the PWM. Now let's start changing the code. Since we need an oscillator frequency of 500 kHz, we are going to change the internal oscillator frequency select bit to 3. So we have the value set as 3 to make it for 500 kHz. Then we have the UART initialization, which we're going to change to 103 and then 001 to match the state of the highlighted area in the data sheet. And then we go to timer 2 and we change the prescaler to 16, which corresponds to 3. And then our PR2 register, which is going to set the frequency for our PWM to 156 so that we can produce 50 Hz PWM frequency. And then we just set the output to the minimum, which I've defined as 16 in the PWM count. And we just quickly compile. Code's happy. Now in the main loop, what I'm going to do is, if I receive a plus character, I am going to increase the duty cycle. So increase the rotation on the server. And then when I send a minus character, I am going to decrease the angle of the server. Okay, first we start with if PWM count is greater than 16, then we nest another if. We say the data, which is the variable that is used to capture the value of the UART, is equivalent to character minus. We decrease the value of PWM count by 1. And now to increase the value, we say if PWM count is less than 76, then we copy the if statement again, we change PWM count to increment the PWM value, and then the character changes to plus. And then at the end of the execution, we simply add set PWM to change the values in the register so we can have an output. Now we program the PIC. Now just a note before we have a look at the servo turning, is you need to change the define of your XDAL frequency and COM bits to 500,000. This is not that important for this specific tutorial, but if you want to use the delay functions or any of the built-in functions, this can really mess up your day. Now I'm going to hold down the plus key on my computer via PuTTY to increase the server's degrees. And then I maxed it out, and now I'm going to decrease it. In my next video, I'm going to create a graphic interface with Python to set the server outputs. And that's a basic introduction to using a server with a PIC. Any parts that I've used will be linked down in the description. Any code that I've written will be shared on my Git. A like, share, comment, and subscribe would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.